visit our temple. I'm going there someday to feel the Holy Spirit, to listen and to pray. For the temple is a house of God, a place of love and beauty. I'll prepare myself while I am young. This is a sacred duty. I love to see the temple. I'm going inside someday. I'll covenant with my Father. I'll promise to obey. For the temple is a holy place where we are sealed together. As a child of God, I learn this truth. Our family is forever.
Do you know why ordinances are so special? No? They're kind of like gateways. They're kind of like gates that are open that allow Heavenly Father's power to flow. In Doctrine and Covenants, Joseph Smith talked about, in the ordinances thereof, the power of godliness is manifest. Sit up, Carter. So that's what we just witnessed, and that's what your baptism today is. It's a special ordinance. And whenever there's an ordinance, it's an invitation to receive power from Heavenly Father. That's really what it is. So, a few remarks on baptism. Do you know what the symbolism of baptism is, sweetie? A symbol is like something that tells of a deeper truth. It's like, I'm going to read here from, I'm going to ask Grandma Cook to read here. Romans chapter 6, verses 2 through 5.
God forbid, how shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? Know ye not that so many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? Therefore we are buried with him by baptism into death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in a newness of life. For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall also be in the likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin.
So I know that's a lot to hear, sweetie. So when you go down in the water, you go completely in the water, huh? And that's kind of like when someone's buried, right? When they're buried, they're completely in the ground. We don't leave like fingers and toes and hair above the ground and the rest of the body buried, do we?
That'd be scary.
That would be a little weird. So that's in the same likeness as Jesus. When Jesus, not only his baptism, but his own death and resurrection. So it symbolizes something amazing, that you're giving up being just Grace Nicole Clark. And now you're choosing to be a follower, a disciple of Jesus Christ. Almost like you carry his last name. Like you could say Grace Nicole Clark Christ, almost. That's more or less what it's symbolizing. That you experience newness of life. And that's the beauty of the ordinances of the gospel. They help us to experience a heightened level of life. You've only experienced so much life, and now the chains are taken away from you, and you experience more and more and more gifts and powers and blessings and privileges. The other scripture I wanted to share is in 2 Nephi. I'm going to ask Carter Clark to read this.
We love hearing his reading voice.
I don't even know how to read.
I heard you read yesterday.
Okay. Verses 5 through 8. Yes. 5 through 8.
The
And now if the Lamb of God, he being holy, should have need to be baptized by water to fulfill all righteousness, oh then how much more need have we, being unholy, to be baptized, yea, even by water? And now I would ask of you, my beloved brethren, wherein the Lamb of God did fulfill all righteousness in being baptized by water? Know ye not that he was holy, notwithstanding he being holy, he showed unto the children of men that according to the flesh he mumbleth himself before the Father, and witnesseth unto the Father that he would be obedient unto him in keeping his commandments. Wherefore, after he was baptized upon him in the form of the dove,
the Holy Ghost descended upon him.
Perfect. So, whose example are you following, sweetie?
What? Whose example? Who did Carter just read about that, even though he was holy, to fulfill all righteousness, he demonstrated an example to us?
Jesus.
That's right. That's right. It's a sign and a symbol to heaven that you're willing to follow, that you're humble, and that you want something more in your life. So, after you're baptized, there's a baptism of water. Do you know what the second baptism is? What do you think, Mommy?
It's the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Baptism by fire. You get burned.
So we're gonna
in a good way.
The brown on the face.
So, Mommy's going to read this scripture
about the baptism of fire in the Holy Ghost, verse 13.
Wherefore, my beloved brethren, I know that if ye shall follow the Son with full purpose of heart, acting no hypocrisy and no deception before God, but with real intent, repenting of your sins, witnessing unto the Father that ye are willing to take upon you the name of Christ by baptism, yea, by following your Lord and your Savior down into the water, according to his word, behold, then shall ye receive the Holy Ghost. Oh, you're good. Yea, then cometh the baptism of
fire.
Right.
And of the Holy Ghost. And then can ye speak with the tongue of angels and shout praises unto the Holy One of Israel.
So, what's your experience with the baptism of fire and of the Holy Ghost?
You want me to do that now, or do you want me to do it when I'm bearing my testimony?
Well, you can do it when you're bearing. I'll just. So, Grace, we love you greatly. This baptism you're going to experience today helps prepare you for the greater baptism. It's a sign and a symbol that you're willing and ready and earnest and anxious to receive the real baptism, which is the baptism of fire and of the Holy Ghost. It cleanses you and makes you a new creature. I've experienced it in my life, sweetie. And you literally can and you will speak with the tongue of angels. Your voice becomes angelic and everything you say heals. Everything you touch comes to life. You literally have that power and that ability, and you're going to be given that opportunity to receive that gift. It doesn't just come just by us laying our hands on you, but it gives you the exhortation to receive it. Gives you the invitation that you can receive it. And it's the most amazing sensation in the world. You can imagine, what's your most favorite food? If you're eating gummy bears and Airheads and all the candy in the world, and multiply that, the taste of that sugar, the sweetness of that sugar by a million times, and it's not even beginning to come close to how sweet the Holy Ghost feels and tastes. It's like the sweetest, that's what Lehi said, the sweetest above all that is sweet, the purest above all that is pure. So white, so pure, so heavenly, like you're biting into the most heavenly mint Oreo cookie you could ever imagine. That's what I liken it to. And I feel that, sweetie, and I've felt that many times. And the greatest thing I want for my kids is for you guys to feel that, because it makes life absolutely worth living. It makes every difficulty, sorrow, challenge, struggle you've ever had just evaporate. It just melts away in the love that just pours out from the ministering of the Holy Ghost to you. It's the most amazing feeling in the world. And I'm just honored that you can be my daughter and that you can have the opportunity to feel that, because that's what unites. It's what gives life. It's what gives us the feeling of hope, of goodness, of love, of kindness, of everything that's worthy and desirable in life. And I know that that's true. And I want more than anything for you to feel and experience that. You were born, you came into a family, you have spiritual genes in your DNA. Your grandparents, on both sides, very, very spiritual people. And I know all you kids feel that. Even though you live in a tumultuous time, a different time than mom and dad, different time than Brother Wing's Bishop Wing's generation, but you still have that sensitivity, you still have that DNA within you, it's sugar. You still have that DNA within you that knows and knows when it feels spiritual things. Come on in, it's fine. No, it knows when it feels spiritual things and it yearns and craves for it. That's you guys crave for it, whether you recognize it or not. And I just want you to feel that and feel okay that you have that. And I'm so grateful for you. And I say that in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen. Amen.
So what I'm going to do is we're going to give anybody the opportunity, kind of like a testimony meeting if you want, to say something to Grace, to share something they've learned, share something that would be beneficial, that would invite the Spirit. And then after we're done with that, we're going to sing... I'm a child of God. I'm a child of God. And then it'll be going to
the church. I just had a question, though. How's the water? How do you think it's doing?
Probably mid to half.
Is it going very fast?
I didn't turn it full
okay.
up, but it
was
decently.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's good. Yes.
We get there and we're all
isolated. Is that responsible for the building?
Yeah.
We don't want it to flood in.
No.
We'd like to welcome our oldest son, Sugar Jacob, the telephone.
Hey, he's baby.
So, anybody else that's like to is able to share?
Yeah, when you were talking, I was thinking about Grace. When your dad was talking about the Holy Ghost and how it feels, what I liken it to is when you realize, and this is for everyone here, I think, when you realize that you have done something that you feel and you know it's approved by Father. You've listened to the Holy Ghost and you've done something and you know without a doubt that this has come to you, that you have been given this information, you've used it appropriately, and it has blessed your life, or blessed others. And that has happened to me a lot over the years. I've been in the church since I was 30, almost 36 years. And I didn't always recognize it at first, because I was in a different churches and jumping up, and the Spirit was supposed to be really loud. It's a very small voice, but when we're doing things, this Holy Ghost will help you in school, it can help you in sports, it can help you anywhere with all sorts of things. It helps me a lot being bishop, and when I'm supposed to do things, and in primary and all these other things, it helps me, it helps you when you're listening to the teachers and your mom and dad when they're teaching. And you learn things, don't you? And you know that they're true, don't you? And how do you know they're true? Because of the Holy Ghost. And I can testify. It's one of the greatest things is knowing that there's that you've prayed about something really hard. It comes to fruition. You can see Father's hand in it, the Savior, and you know you've been inspired from it. And I'm sure all of you have been there at one time or another, but seems to be, since I've been bishop, it's been more and more, maybe because I'm praying a lot more for a lot more people. And it really manifests itself a lot. And it really lets you know that the Book of Mormon is true and all sorts of other things. And I leave this with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
I could go on, but I won't.
I want to talk... I got you this really special gift. You know what it is? What is it?
It's an elephant puzzle.
An elephant puzzle. And what does it say right here?
It's a crystal puzzle.
A crystal puzzle, which means it's what color?
Crystal.
Yeah.
Means it's crystal clear, right? So there's lots of different analogies I can make with this. I saw this and I thought, this is perfect for baptism. Because life to me is like a puzzle, okay? And there's lots and lots of pieces. And as you go along and you grow, every year you're adding new pieces to your puzzle and you're becoming more whole, right? So baptism is one of the most important pieces to your puzzle. Without that, you're always going to have a big hole and you won't be an elephant. Or little girl or whatever, right? And later on, you'll add more pieces to your puzzle. Like you'll go to the temple or getting the gift of the Holy Ghost will be another piece to your puzzle. And you'll just keep growing and growing and becoming more, your purpose in life will become more clear. Like sometimes when we do a puzzle, you start out and it's really messy and you don't know where to start and it's hard to put it together, right? And you make little baby steps and baby progress until it starts coming together. And then you see, oh, I know what this is going to be, right? You ever done that with a puzzle before? Especially if we don't have the picture. When we come here to life, we're not given the picture. We're given the plan of salvation that tells us, you know, who we are, where we're going. But a lot of people out there aren't given that picture. They're not given any part of the picture. And they just have to go figure it out. So we're given a lot of pieces of our puzzle. But even when you fill out the entire puzzle that you've been given on earth, there's always going to be a missing piece. You know why? Because Christ holds that piece. And what I call that is His grace. And that's why we named you Grace. You know that? It's one of the reasons, the definition of grace, in my mind, is basically the final piece of the puzzle. Because without Christ, we'd never be whole. We always have something missing in our life. So His grace, you are like a huge blessing. And His grace makes us whole when we're sad or when we're lost or we're scared or we don't know where to go. We can always go to Heavenly Father or pray because of Jesus Christ. And the gift that you're given today with the Holy Ghost is going to be that knowing, that answer. When you're scared and you don't know what part of the puzzle is supposed to go next, He'll give you the answer and He'll tell you how to feel whole. And that's my testimony to you. I love you.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, in the name of Jesus Christ.
All right, you guys.
All right, Grace. When I was young, my grandma gave me a necklace when I got baptized. She took me aside and she said, "This is a very special necklace. Do you know what it is?" I looked at it and I said, "I have no idea what that is." She says, "That's a mustard seed. And if you have faith as little as that," and it was the teeniest little seed I'd ever seen, "that you will be able to move mountains." And I thought, I want to move a mountain, really? But as I've grown older, I've come to more understand that scripture. You can move mountains in your life. With faith in Christ, you can go through a lot of really great things and a lot of really hard things and feel His love all of your life. Well, in here, I have a necklace. It's not the mustard seed one, but it's one of my favorite things. If you want to come here, this is your new little purse with a G on it. And this has a flower.
What does that say for Goody?
And this is a flower. And as you plant the seeds of faith, it will grow into a beautiful flower. Or a beautiful plant, a beautiful testimony of Jesus Christ. And I want you to know that I have faith in Jesus Christ, that I know beyond any shadow of a doubt that this is His church. And I'm excited that you're a member and that you are part of the family of Christ now as you get baptized. And I love you. And I want you to use the Holy Ghost every day, because that's a gift. And that's why I tried to put like a G on here. G for grace, G for gift. Because if you use that every day, He will protect you and guide you all of your life. In His name, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
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 You guys want to say anything to your sister?
Congratulations. I love you.
Hi, Gracie. I just want to say that I love you and I'm glad you're my big sister then.
Emberly's not shy. Apparently the rest of them are.
Grace, I just want you to know I love you, okay? And I know that your grandpas are here watching. If I say much more, I'll cry. I just want you to know I love you. If you need more advice than just the Holy Ghost, you can call any one of us or talk to any one of us if you need to make any hard decisions in your life, okay? Just know I love you, and that everybody, even the angels on the other side, are here with you, all excited for you to make this choice.
Did the hiccups?
His name is Christ,
amen. Amen. Thank you. Well, I guess we'll sing I'm a Child of God. Are we doing that instead of the River Jordan song? Okay. Okay, and then we're just going to drive over to the church, and then you guys are welcome to come back and eat with us after if you have time.
What do we eat?
Hamburgers and hot dogs.
Food. Food.
Spiritual food.
Is that a
food?
You might already eat.
You know, eat food. You know, code the code.
All right. Let's just do it.
More than 100 times.
All right. Kaylin's got the song.
Here we go.
Hold on 1 second. I'm
going to
pull it up first. If you're getting the word.
Yeah, I can pull it up for sure.
The music.
We're just singing it. It's closing. Yeah. Can't hear sugar. It's just.
You'll be able to get it out in
time. What pen number is
it? Was it 301?
301. I'm going
to be able to. Hey, by the way, was there warm water coming out when you left?
Yes. All right. Yeah. We had to reset. I still haven't found out about the speakers.
About the speakers? Yeah.
We don't need warm water. We're not going to have one Sunday.
I don't know. I contacted FM Group and they got back to me.
Here we go.
Okay. Sure.
No, what?
Let's just do the first verse. Just do the first verse, Nicole. Let's just do the first verse, I guess.
I am a child of God, and He has sent me here, has given me an earthly home with parents kind and dear. Lead me, guide me, walk beside me, help me find the way. Teach me all that I must do to live with Him someday.
Oh, whoops, sir.